Back again, and today we're going to finish Unit 1 by talking about how to write a personal profile. Remember that we talked about social media profiles, and I showed you a little about my profile, personal and professional, on Instagram. And today you're going to pay attention here about writing a personal profile. Let's check it out. So let's pay attention here. Let's read the profile and identify what kind of social media network this is about, right? Pay attention. Is it professional, dating, or social? Let's check. So, what's a personal profile? And where might you see one? Have you ever written one? What was it for? This is Pete Grill, and we're going to check some information about his personal profile. Let's pay attention to how he writes about his life, his personal information, his profession, and other things. In part B, we have an exercise. You're going to identify the headings of the profile, right? So we have all about me, ambitions, books and music, favorite movies, interests, languages, looking for, travel, work and education. So you're going to identify from 1 to 9, which is the heading for each of the paragraphs. So let's read. Pete Brill. Get connected. Hi, I'm Pete. I'm an adventure-seeking, outgoing, 22-year-old digital media studies graduate. Currently working in TV production and love it. Originally from Copenhagen and now living in London. I love the outdoors and socializing. Looking to meet like-minded, outgoing people for social and work-related connections. PM me. As you can see, number one, he talks about his name, his profile, his age, and some other information like his profession, what he studies, right? And what he likes. In the end of it, he says, PM me. What does PM mean? It means private message, so you can talk to him by sending him a private message, right? So, which heading is in number one? The answer is all about me. Let's go ahead in number two. One Stop Productions, London, production assistant. White Swim Clothing, CEO, London, sales assistant. Metropolitan University, London in 2015 to 2018. And Copenhagen International School from 2007 to 2014. So, what is it about? He gives information about his work and education, right? His professional and his educational life. In number three, pay attention. Anything outdoors. I love skiing, surfing, running, and climbing. Anything adventures. Taking part in four international triathlon events. Eating out. Thai food is my absolute favorite. Know any good restaurants? So which of the headings is the best one for number three? Let's check. Number three, interests. Alright? He mentions here what kind of things he likes. His favorite food, his favorite sports, right? Let's go ahead in number four. Took a gap year and traveled through South America. Highlights were teaching in a kindergarten in Bolivia, seeing Machu Picchu and being in Rio de Janeiro for Mardi Gras. Planning a tour in Norway next summer. So, what is this paragraph about? What heading is the best one? So, number four is travel, right? In this paragraph, he talks about his travel experiences, right? Number five, become a skydiving instructor. Which is the best heading for this one? Number five, ambitions. Do you have dreams? Do you have aims, objectives in your life? Number six, I mostly read nonfiction. Favorite book? Sapiens by Yuval Noah Harari. So, which heading is the best one that matches number 6. Books and music, right? So he talks about he likes to read non-fiction books. His favorite book is this one, Satan. In number 7, he says, anything by Spielberg. I love his imagination. So number 7, favorite movie. And he likes anything by Spielberg. He loves all Spielberg's movies, right? Number 8, Danish, German, English. Which is the heading for this one? Check. This information is about languages. So he speaks English, German, and Danish, right? And the last one, number 9, he says, friendship, running buddies, dinners out, movie trips, deep conversations, party partners, networking. So which is the heading for number 9? So number 9 is something that you are looking for. So he wants more about friendship, running buddies, people who can run together with him, people that he can have dinner out, have deep conversations, go to the parties. Tell me now about what kind of profile is this one? Is it professional, dating, or social? Let's check the answer. It is a social profile. He talks about his personal life, right? In this exercise, we have more information about Pete from letters A to letter H. And these are some missing from the profile. Read again the text and check which part of the text they are perfect match. So we have letter A. Remember here we have in the last part of paragraph in number 1. We have letter A. He presents himself and he tells PM me, right? Private message. So which is letter A? Letter A, I'd love to hear from you. He presents himself and now he wants to hear from the readers, right? Letter B is in the paragraph number 3. He says, anything adventures. So which is the best one for letter B? Let's check the missing information from Pete's profile for letter B. So letter B, just got my motorbike license. Something that he likes to go home. Adventures, experiences, right? And letter C, let's check. In paragraph number 4, letter C is next to planning a tour in Norway next summer. So, which is the best one for number 4? So, letter C is about his trips. So, which is the best one here? It's missing information. Letter C. Unfortunately, I broke my wrist on an Amazon canoeing trip. So, he talks about his travel experience. It was not so good, right? He broke his wrist. Remember wrist? That means pulso, right? Letter D and letter E are in paragraph number 6. He talks about his favorite book, right? And he likes reading non-fiction books, right? So, which is the best one for number 6, letter D and letter E? So, which of the missing information is in letter D and in letter E? As he talks about non-fiction books, he likes to read, right? So, letter D, got any biograph recommendations, right? And the missing information for letter E, which is the best one? Remember that that part of the profile is about books and music, right? So which is the best one for letter E? Remember that he doesn't mention his favorite music, right? So here in letter E, he tells us about his favorite music types. He says, I enjoy live gigs and open mic nights. You see? Letter F is in number 7 about Spielberg's movies, right? So, which is the best one for letter F? As he talks about movies, letter F answer is, I love science fiction too. So, he talks about movies. Number 8, remember, it's about languages. So which is the best one for letter G? The missing information for letter G is tried Mandarin. He talks about his experience trying to learn Mandarin Chinese, right? And the last one, letter H. Letter H is in number 9. He talks about his interest. Remember? So the last one is letter H. Travel companions, travel tips, colleagues. He talks about his interest. Just to remember how to write a personal profile. So in social media profiles, we talk about our personal life, experiences, and other things we want to make. Social media profiles are usually divided into different sections with headings for you to fill in. Example, favorite movies, all about me. To make them quick and easy to read, we often, number one, omit non-essential words such as pronouns and auxiliary verbs. Example, I'm looking forward to meeting you. Number two, use abbreviations. Example, PM, private message, find me on Facebook, FB for Facebook. And number three, we use repeated punctuation marks. Example, any good restaurant recommendations? All right, we repeat the punctuation mark here. And number four, we ask questions to encourage reader interest. Example, know any good old local bands? You see, these are some examples of Pete's profile characteristics that you could see, right? Let's check some of the examples we could find there in Pete's profile. Number one, currently working TV production, originally from Copenhagen, living in London, looking to meet. Just got my motorbike license, taking part in 4, know any good restaurants, took a gap year, highlights were, planning a tour, got any biograph recommendations, tried Mandarin. In number 2, PM me, 3, got any biograph recommendations, and 4, know any good restaurants. So as you can see, Pete reduces the forms of the sentences. He doesn't mention the pronoun, and he also used repeated question mark in the questions. Got any biograph recommendation? And he also used the abbreviation PM for private message, right? And questions to get people's interest, like know any good restaurants? You see? So here is about how to write your own social media profile. Before writing that, you have to decide about the headings you want to include. You don't have to complete all of them, right? You can mention other things. Now, guys, we're going to start Unit 2, right? And the topic is about environmental issues. We're going to see some natural disasters, some endangered species, and also debating about going green. So by studying this lesson, we're going to identify what we have been doing for our environment and what we should have been doing. We're going to have a quiz about analyzing our actions about environment. So what we should be doing? Let's check a video now about reducing, reusing, and recycling to protect our earth. Let's check. We're going green. We're gonna take care of the earth. We're going green. You can go green at your home or school. Reduce, reuse, and recycle. Reduce. Be careful how long you take a shower. You don't need to stand there for 70 hours. Turn off the water when you're brushing your teeth and only use the necessary energy. Turn off the lights when they're not in use. Think how much electricity you produce. Take quick drinks, walk to school. Reducing energy is really cool. Pull out plugs when you're not using them. Turn off the computer every now and then. Throw away litter, pick up trash, and you'll save the earth in a flash. We're going green. We're going green. We're gonna take care of the earth. We're going green. You can go green at your home or school. Reduce,
reuse rags. Donate toys so someone else can use them. Donate clothes, don't just lose them. We're going green. We're going green. We're gonna take care of the earth. We're going green. You can go green at your home or school. Reduce, reuse, and recycle. Just throwing away is not enough. Recycle some things to make new stuff, like paper, cans, and plastic too. Glass and cardboard out the wazoo. Game CDs and DVDs, light bulbs, cartridges, and batteries. Laptops, cell phones, and the news. Lots of metals you can choose. We're going green.
So, after watching that video about going green, I invite you to a reflection. Let's go green. Take a look at these photos. From 1 to 10, you're going to check how they are connected to environment. So, how they are connected with being green. Take a look at the example. Well, number 1 is plastic bottles. I think it takes a lot of energy to produce them. Yes, and the oceans are full of plastic waste. So take a look at the suggested answers. Number 1, plastic bottles pollute the ocean. Number 2, appliances use a lot of electricity. What are appliances? They are objects that we use connected to the electricity, especially to clean, cool. Number 3, it takes a lot of energy to produce a styrofoam cup. Number 4, these types of light bulbs save energy. Light bulbs are a device used to convert electricity into light. Number 5, this is renewable energy. Number 6, lots of waste isn't recycled. Number 7, your carbon footprint measures how much carbon your actions cause in the world. 8, this can avoid using polluting plastic bags. And number 9, eating meat has a big impact on the environment. The last one, number 10, it's important not to waste water. To waste here as a verb means to use without purpose. That means desperdiçar, right? So let's read together. Open your book on page 18. You're gonna read, and after you're gonna match the highlighted words in the quiz according to the photos. Remember the photos? So you're going to read the text with me, and then you're going to match the photos according to the number here with the text. Let's start.
The Going Green Quiz. We all know what we should be doing, but how green have you really gone? 1. Leaving appliances on standby mode isn't environment friendly because it wastes energy. Do you always unplug your computer or cell charger when not in use? 2. Disposable plastic bags can take up to 1,000 years to decompose. Do you reuse plastic bags or take a reusable cloth bag when you go shopping? 3. Leaving the faucet running when you brush your teeth twice a day can waste almost 8 gallons of water. Do you turn the faucet off while brushing your teeth? 4. Energy-efficient light bulbs last from 6,000 to 15,000 hours. Do you use energy-efficient light bulbs in your house or office? 5. Solar heating is a renewable energy source, and it can help you save as much as 1/3 off your monthly power bill. Does your house or apartment building have a solar heating system? 6. It takes more than 30 million barrels of oil a year to make the plastic for the world's bottled water. Do you use refillable bottles for water at home? 7. A styrofoam cup takes 500 years to decompose. Do you use styrofoam cups at work or home? 8. A typical American family produces 30% more household waste than a typical Mexican family. Do you separate organic and non-organic household waste? 9. More than 1.5 million Americans over the age of 17 are now vegan. Flexitarianism is now on the increase, with a 60% global rise in new vegetarian-branded products between 2011 and 2015. Do you ever eat vegetarian meal? 10. A carbon footprint calculates all the greenhouse gases we produce in our activities as individuals and measures them in units of carbon dioxide. The world average is about 4.5 tons of carbon dioxide per person. Do you ever feel concerned about your carbon footprint?
The word flexitarianism is a noun. Following a vegetarian diet with the occasional inclusion of meat. This is the definition. So let's do the exercise by matching the photos from 1 to 10. So let's start reading. We all know what we should be doing. Going green quiz. But how green have you really gone? So let's check the answers. You're gonna match, remember, the photos with the words that are highlighted. So the first one, the picture number one, is about the bottle water. Number two, it is appliance. What is an appliance? It is any device that we use connected to the electricity for cooking, for phone, that we call electrodomestic. Number three, they are the styrofoam cups, right? See here in the picture. And number four, they are the light bulb, the energy efficient light bulb. Number five, can you see here in the picture? On the roof of the house is the solar heating. Number six, household waste, things that we won't use anymore. They mean desperdício, has. Number seven is the carbon footprint. Number eight, reusable cloth bag. And number nine, can you see? A lot of fruit and vegetables, vegan. Number 10, it is the faucet. Can you see the water running? So the faucet is running. Pay attention to this. It's a very common mistake people make, right? Instead of using the verb left, we use the verb left in the past. So you say, I left the lights on. You don't use I left, all right? And the next example, this fridge wastes a lot of energy. We don't use the word spend in this sense, right? But waste. Waste means desperdiçar. Now, let's do this exercise. You're going to put these words in the correct column according to the underlying sound. So pay attention to the sound we have. We have two sounds, the sound in bottle and the sound in close. You see? Bottle, off, and close, oh, right? So we have the words here. You're going to pay attention and check by listening the words into the column of bottle or the column of close. Let's listen.
Sock, clock.
Bottle, cloth, product.
Oh, nose. Rose.
Clothes. Disposable. Eco. Program. Solar. Styrofoam.
So let's check the answers. The words like in bottle, we have sock, clock, bottle, cloth, product. The pronunciation is off. And O, like in nose, rose, clothes, disposable, eco, program, solar, and styrofoam. In this exercise, you're going to pay attention to the green adjectives by adding able, efficient, and friendly to the verbs or nouns, right? You're going to match the endings to their meanings. So we have number one, reusable cloth bag. Number two, energy efficient light bulb. And number three, environment friendly appliances. So, how do you match these words to the meaning that are safe for, that you use less, that you can, plus a verb? Pay attention to the adjectives from verbs and nouns. We use the suffixes able, efficient, and friendly. Take a look at the examples. I only use rechargeable batteries in my device. She bought a very space-efficient one. The software is really user-friendly. We form adjectives by adding able, efficient, and friendly to verbs and nouns. Able means can be done. Drinkable, breakable, doable. Verbs ending in E, because the E and we have able.
Example, reuse, reuse, be able by adding, and then we have reusable. Love, lovable. Recycle, recyclable. The exception is rechargeable, that we don't cut the letter E, right? Use a hyphen between nouns and efficient or friendly. Example, she bought an energy efficient washing machine. We took our nephews to a child-friendly restaurant. Take a look at the picture. Glad to see folks like you using reusable shopping bags. We're saving a lot of trees. Here is your prompt. So, in this exercise, you're going to create 7 sentences, green sentences, using the suffixes that we studied in exercise A. Remember, able in the end of the word, efficient, and friendly. Remember to use the hyphen to separate the words using friendly and efficient, right? So, number 1, we have water and fossil. 2, environment and detergent. 3, fuel and vehicle. 4, recharge and batteries. 5, energy and appliances. 6, reuse plastic containers. 7, pest and insecticides. So let's do them. The answers are, pay attention to the answers. Listen. Now, take a look at some essential green terms and phrases that we can use. Pay attention to the words. Do you know any of these words? Zero waste, repair, cafe, sustainable, biodegradable, compostable, single use, upcycle, greenwashing. So let's take a look at some of them.
1. Water efficient faucet. 2. Environment friendly detergents. 3. Fuel efficient vehicles. 4. Rechargeable batteries. 5. Energy-efficient appliances. 6. Reusable water bottle. 7. Pet-friendly insecticides.
Now you're gonna watch a video and pay attention about the impact this guy is talking about, right? Let's watch the video.
We've got so many ways we can be green.
It started out as an experiment. I wanted to see if I could leave no impact on the environment for an entire year, and I asked myself, was it possible I could become a happier person by reducing my impact on the environment?
And the answer I found out is a resounding yes.
So I started by cutting out garbage, taxis, throwaway coffee cups. I eliminated tomatoes in the middle of January, AC in the dead of August, bottled water from France, and new clothing from who knows where. I saved money, lost weight, gained energy, improved my health, spent more quality time with my family and friends, renewed my relationship with my wife, and discovered an overall sense of freedom. I learned that yes, sometimes less is more.
So, take a look at this poster. In your opinion, No Impact Man, the video that you just watched, is it a comic? Is it a documentary? What do you think it is about? Do you think he's some kind of superhero? So let's check. It's a documentary about a man who performed an experiment to have no impact on the environment for a year. So he was kind of a superhero, don't you think? So let's listen, pay attention to the audio script.
It started out as an experiment. I wanted to see if I could leave no impact on the environment for an entire year. And I asked myself, was it possible I could become a happier person by reducing my impact on the environment? And the answer I found out is a resounding yes. So I started by cutting out garbage, taxis, throwaway coffee cups. I eliminated tomatoes in the middle of January, AC in the dead of August, bottled water from France, and new clothing from who knows where. I saved money, lost weight, gained energy, improved my health, spent more quality time with my family and friends, renewed my relationship with my wife, and discovered an overall sense of freedom. I learned that, yes, sometimes less is more.
Did you like that? What about you? What have you done to reduce an impact on the environment. Have you done anything? What would you do if you had the chance to leave no impact on the environment? What thing would you reduce? What thing would you reuse or recycle? Do you remember what Colin said about these items? Waste, travel and transportation, food and drink, shopping, money, health, relationships, and happiness. So let's try to remember some of the things that he said. So let's remember what Colin said about the impact on the environment. Remember that he said he could become a happier person by reducing the impact on the environment. So what did he do? Remember here he said, I started by cutting out garbage, taxes, throwaway coffee cups. He also eliminated tomatoes in the middle of the nary and bottled water from France, new clothing from who knows where. He saved money. He lost weight. He gained energy. He improved his health. He spent more quality time with his family and friends. And also renewed his relationship with his wife, right? And finally, he discovered an overall sense of freedom. So, let's answer the questions here. So, let's take a look at the answers. Waste, he said. He cut out garbage and threw away coffee cups. Travel and transportation, he said he cut out taxes. About food and drink, what did he do? He stopped buying tomatoes in January and bottled water from France, right? And he saved money. So, this is about money. He saved money too. About shopping, he stopped buying new clothing. About money, he saved the money that I mentioned before. About his health, he lost weight, he gained energy, and he became healthier, right? About his relationships, he said he spent more time with friends, family, and wife, right? And about happiness, he became happier. So, what about you? What can you do to become a happier person? Maybe some changes about your health, about your weight, about your lifestyle. Do you want to change something? So, any big differences that you want to make in your life, make some changes? Number one, why do you think he made this change? What impact will they have on the environment? Number two, what three things could you change to have less impact on the environment? And number three, would you consider going no impact for a year, a month, a week? Why or why not? So these questions here, we're going to discuss about them in our next live. Be there, participate, and give your opinion. Answer these questions. They're part of your AP too, right? Don't forget it.